Hello YouTube, K4DPS back again looking at the Whistler WS1095 new digital base mobile scanner. I was asked by one of my subscribers, hey, can you just show us the basics and just the front of what each button does? So great question and thank you for asking. We'll start over here to the left right here. This is our headphone jack, so you can put in your headphones and listen nice and quiet. Have a headset plugged in. Right underneath that is the USB cable. Scanner comes with the mini USB to regular USB cable, and that's where you plug that in for programming. Over here is your menu button. So in order to get into the main menu, you just press that button right there. It has your scan list, set location, browse library, browse objects, enter conventional frequency settings, scan sets, search, vscanner, restore skipped, update from library, set clock, set password, playback, and that's on your main menu there. Alrighty, go back to scan. In order to scan, that's your SEL or selection button. This is your player pause. When the scanner stops on a talk group and or channel frequency, you can pause on that by using that button that I just used. AT&T is your attenuation. If you press that once, you have your GA is global attenuation. Press it again, it's just global. And that is, you would use that button if you had strong signals that were coming in on your scanner. That will actually attenuate those down. I haven't had any issues, knock on wood. No reason to use that. And I'm actually using an outside antenna. All right, this right here is your Skywarn button. What does that mean? Well, you can program in certain frequencies, maybe that the ham radio operators have a local repeater system. Like when I lived in Missouri, we had a main repeater that everybody that was a Skywarn member used. You can program that in there. For now, if you press that, it's going to give you the local weather. To get it back to scan, just hit the play, pause, select button right there. All right, this right here is your volume up and volume down. There's actually two ways that you can increase it or decrease your volume. You can either do it by the pad right here, or you can use this knob right here. So either way. Also, in order to adjust the squelch, this knob right here, if you press it in, you'll see the squelch level come up, and you can adjust the squelch level. On this particular one, it looks like squelch level 9. I know that sounds high, but it seems like that's about the best squelch level for me is a 9. Of course, your mileage may vary, as people like to say, depending on where you're located. Right here is the skip button. If for any reason there's a channel, talk group, frequency that you just want to skip, maybe it's not, you know, maybe it's a nuisance, or maybe they're talking about something that really don't care about, all you have to do is hit the skip button. It'll skip over it. You can actually go into the main menu and review your skips. So if you go, oh man, I wish I hadn't skipped that, you can go back and actually take that out of there. Of course, you have the right and left, and this automatically takes you into browser. You can go through each one of the scan lists that you have in there. Here, let me get my finger out of the way. Each one of the scan lists, and you can go up and down and check and see exactly what channels and what frequencies you have in each scan list, which is a very nice feature. Go back to scan. You'll get the menu button, menu, again to get back to the main menu, then hit the select. I am new to this scanner, as you can tell. I've made a few mistakes in my past videos, and hey, you know what? That's all part of learning, you know? Another subscriber said, "Well, you've made some mistakes. I'm really surprised you actually published those videos." But you know what? That's how you learn. If you don't make mistakes, then you're not learning. So as long as you don't keep making mistakes over and over again, and you actually learn something from your mistakes, then I don't mind publishing them. That's the way that I've always been. Anyway, this is your power button right here. You can do a light level. See how the light level came on? Just by pressing it for about, I guess, about a half a second, you can actually adjust the light intensity. This is high. I had it set on 4 right there. And so you can adjust your light level. So there you go. That's the front. The buttons, pretty easy to use. And like I said, I'm still making a ton of mistakes on how to use this thing. But I really, really like this scanner. So far, so good. Really good receiver. Picking up a lot of good systems near and far. So far, so good, Whistler. Anyway. Thank you very much for watching my videos, and thank you for subscribing to my channel. I appreciate you. Have a great day.